You guys are amazing. The last ESP32 deep sleep video blew up, and the comments section was an absolute goldmine of incredible questions. You asked, how do I wake it up with a button? How do I turn off Wi-Fi? How do I squeeze out even more battery life? Today, we're answering your questions with real code examples that will give your ESP32 projects battery-saving superpowers. Let's do this. But first, I just want to take a moment to say thank you for watching. Every view, every comment, every like really helps this channel grow, and it means a lot. I'm just one person in my workshop sharing what I learn. When you click that like and subscribe button, it does more than just help the channel grow. It tells me that these videos are genuinely helping you. I promise you, I read every single comment. This entire video is proof of that. Your feedback directly shapes what we explore next. So thank you for being a part of this. It truly means the world. All right, enough talk. Let's dive into your amazing questions. First up, one of the most asked questions from users. In our last video, we used a timer to wake the ESP32. But what if you need to wake it up for a real-world event, like a door opening or a button press? For this, we need to use an external wake-up. The secret is a special function called ESP Deep Sleep Enable GPIO Wake-Up. This lets us pick a specific pin to act as a trigger. But here's the catch. You can't use just any pin. It has to be an RTC-capable GPIO pin. Think of these as the pins that never truly sleep. They're connected to the real-time clock, which stays powered on even when the main CPU is off. I have QR codes and links in the description to the official docs so you can find the right pins for your board. Okay, check this out. Our ESP32 is in deep sleep, sipping just microamps of power. It's waiting. Now, let's simulate a door opening by pressing this button. Boom, instant wake up. The ESP32 comes to life, runs its code, and after a few seconds, it goes right back to sleep, waiting for the next event. For any project that needs to react to the real world, this is a total game changer. All the code for this example is waiting for you in the description below, or you can use the QR code here. But deep sleep has one big limitation. Every wake up is a full reboot, which means it forgets everything it was doing. What if you just need to pause for a second without losing your place? This is where our next topic, inspired by your comments, comes in: light sleep. In light sleep, the CPU pauses, but the RAM stays powered on. When it wakes up, it resumes exactly where it left off. No reboot. It's faster, but uses a bit more power than deep sleep. Now, there are two ways to do this. First, the more advanced way, using the official ESP-IDF or Expressif IoT Development Framework. This is a more advanced setup, using something like Platform.io in VS Code. But the payoff is huge. By enabling a couple of settings in a configuration file, the ESP32 can automatically enter light sleep during any delay. Watch this. Look at that, the current plummets during the delay, all without us writing a single extra line of code in our main loop. That's the power of automatic power management. But what if you love the simplicity of the Arduino IDE? Don't worry, we can trigger light sleep manually. The magic command here is ESP, light, sleep, start. You can use this as a super low power replacement for the standard delay function. It's a fantastic way to save energy during idle moments inside your main loop. Okay, this next one is really cool. What if you could tell your ESP32's brain to just slow down? Your ESP32 doesn't always need to run at full speed. For simple tasks, we can manually lower the CPU frequency to save a ton of power. Using the set CPU frequency megahertz function, we can easily switch between, say, 160 megahertz for heavy lifting and 40 megahertz for just cruising. You can see the difference right there. Slower speed means lower power draw. But this leads to one of the most important lessons in battery life. It's a common trap to think that lower power draw always equals better battery life. But what really matters is the total energy used to complete a task. In our tests, running a task at 40 megahertz drew only 12 milliamps, but it took 11 seconds. Running at 160 megahertz drew a much higher 30 milliamps, but it finished the job in just 2 seconds, when you crunch the numbers. Running faster used less than half the total energy. The lesson is critical. Get the job done as fast as possible, then get back to sleep. Sometimes, sprinting is more efficient than jogging. Now for the big one. The single most power-hungry part of your ESP32 is the radio. Wi-Fi and Bluetooth are absolute battery killers. If your project only needs to connect once in a while, you must turn them off when they're not in use. Thankfully, it's super simple. After you're done connecting, you just disconnect and then set the Wi-Fi mode to Wi-Fi off. The drop is instant and significant. This is one of the easiest and most effective power-saving tricks in the book. And don't forget, if you use the deep sleep mode from our original video, it automatically turns off the radios for you. I know we've covered a lot of code and concepts really quickly. If you want to go over all of this at your own pace, with detailed explanations and all the code snippets ready to copy and paste, you're in luck. I've written a massive companion article on my website that goes through every single one of these examples in detail. You can scan the QR code on your screen right now, or just click the link at the top of the video description to check it out. So there you have it, four more powerful techniques to add to your arsenal, all inspired by you. We've learned how to wake up with external events, use light sleep to preserve our code state, manually control CPU speed, and disable the power-hungry Wi-Fi radio. The best approach is almost always a combination of these methods, tailored perfectly to your project. Now, it's your turn. I've put links to all the code we covered today in the description below. Take it, use it, and build something incredible. And I want to know what you're going to build. A smart mailbox? A wildlife camera trigger? A super secret spy gadget? Let me know in the comments below. Your ideas could inspire the next video. Thanks for building with me. Now go make something awesome.